Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to the ballpark at Throwville Marion Stadium as we are getting you set for Colt League World Series game number 11, as it will feature Tijuana, Mexico, as they get ready to take on Chiba, Japan here this afternoon. About 3 o'clock Central Time here as we are working our way through a schedule that was messed up last night due to storms in the area that knocked the power out here at the stadium. So we're having to make up games after what was originally scheduled as a 5-game day turning into a 8-game day. And it's going to be Chiba Japan that comes to the plate as the visiting team here this afternoon against this Tijuana, Mexico team. It'll be Fuma Tanaka that leads things off for Japan. Kanatani will hit second, and Matsumoto will hit third, the designated hitter. 1 Ortiz will do the pitching for Tijuana, Mexico. Behind him, Jesus Olivares in left, Oscar Torres in center, Diego Gutierrez in right, Santiago Ballesteros at third, Arturo Blankenson at short, and the first pitch has popped up down the right field line and coming in and making the catch, Diego Gutierrez for the first out here in the top of the first inning. Gustavo Oviedo is at second, Carlos Montiel at first, Eric Atondo doing the catching, and one pitch and one out from Juan Ortiz. Reynosuke Kanatani is the number 2 hitter for Chiba Japan. Curveball on the outside corner for strike 1. 84 degrees here at game time, 89 on the feels like temp. Winds out of the northeast at 6. That means they're blowing out toward right field. That right back off of the pitcher, off his foot and up his leg. He seems like he's okay. He reaches down. Ortiz does, picks it up and flips it to first for the second out. That's a hard hit ground ball, and Ortiz seems like he's okay. He's trying to walk it off a little bit. Trainer will come out to check on him, but he seems like he's okay. Hit right off of the right foot, right in front of the ankle area. He's rolling it around. Tough kid, though. I think he'll be fine. He says, I'm good. Gives the thumbs up. They're going to give him a couple of pitches just to make sure that he's okay. Tornosuke Karanami is coming to the plate. He'll be the third batter here for Chiba Japan. As Ortiz looks like he's good. Scary play as that one hit right off his foot, came up right back to him, and he threw out the runner at first base. So two up, two down, and Ortiz, the pitch, swing and a miss for Matsumoto. Ro Matsumoto hits from the left side. Here is the 0-1 pitch, swing and a miss, strike 2. 71 mile an hour pitch from Juan Ortiz. Here is the 0-2 in the dirt. Tijuana, Mexico. Were beat by Marion earlier this morning, 6-0. Marion will play the late game tonight against Youngstown, Ohio. Here's the pitch from Ortiz, fouled off at the plate. Japan beat Aroma Park yesterday, 23-0. This is a very good Japan team. Fundamentally sound, as they always are. Missing outside with the pitch, even the count, 2-2. Glad to have you wherever you're located watching this Colt World Series. Here is the 2-2 pitch. Get way inside. Runs the count full now. Full count to Matsumoto from the left side of the batter's box. Juan Ortiz begins his delivery. The throw, line toward right field down that foul line and caught out there by Gutierrez. So three up, three down for Team Japan here in the first inning. And Tijuana, Mexico is coming to the bat for the first time. Thank you for tuning in and watching this 2023 Colt League World Series. Bottom of the first inning is Tijuana, Mexico. Comes to the plate. It'll be Gustavo Oviedo. Oviedo squares to bunt, pulls back, and takes ball one high. Game number 11 of this Colt World Series. One ball, one strike to Oviedo. Gustavo playing second base today. Takes one for strike two. And here's the pitch from Oyodo Okanishi. the starting pitcher for Chiba Japan. Behind him, we'll set the defense here momentarily. That's it. Foul out of play. Koronami in left. Funesian in center. Tanaka in right. Noye at third. Fujita at short. Kanatani at second. Sasaki at first. And Koinoga at catcher. Fly ball toward right. And that is caught by Tanaka out in right field for out number one. And now Arturo Blankenson will come to the plate for Tijuana, Mexico.
Number three, Arturo Blankenson.
That's a swing and a miss by Blankenson. Toyonaga is the catcher, and this one is booted out at short. So Blankenson reaches, and that is going to be E6.
Abraham.
Favela at the plate, fist bumps the catcher from Japan. Love the sportsmanship here in this Colt World Series and home plate umpire. And a look over at the runner at first in Blankenson forces him back. Here's the pitch, a little bit high. We've seen three teams bow out of the tournament here today. Hit towards center field. Center fielder Funijin makes the catch. Barely. Really had to reach out as he was sliding over. I think he lost it in the sun as he was looking up. And he indicates that he did. So two down. And Eric Atondo, the catcher, batting cleanup, comes to the plate here. With the runner at first, two down. You're in the bottom of the first for Tijuana, Mexico. Strike one. To Atondo. That one a little bit low. Evens the count, one ball, one strike with two outs. They're playing Atondo incredibly deep in center. Fenian. Oh, he found the hole in right field. Slap hit toward right, the runner from first, and Blankenson winds up at third. The hit and run was on and executed perfectly by the catcher, Eric Atondo. Good pace running by Arturo Blankenson. And now, Tijuana, Mexico, with runners at the corners and two down. Perfectly executed hit and run.
Now batting the third baseman, number 12, Santiago Ballesteros
comes to the plate. Santiago with an RBI opportunity here with a runner just 90 feet away at third base. Boy, that was an outstanding piece of hitting by Atondo.
Courtesy runner at first base, number one, Dominic Hernandez.
Dominic Hernandez, the courtesy runner at first. There's a bad ground ball, third base side glove, throw across in time. Outstanding by Inouye to gun down Ballesteros for the third out. 5-3 on the putout. And that is going to end the bottom of the first inning. Good baseball so far here. As we head to the top of the second, it'll be Chiba Japan coming to the plate here at the 2023 Colt League World Series. Toronosuke Kurenami will lead off the top of the second inning for Chiba Japan. They've yet to pick up a hit. They went 1-2-3 in the top of the first inning. Kurenami, the number four hitter in the lineup, leads off here in the second inning. Takes a pitch for strike one, evens the count 1-1. Juan Ortiz continues to throw for Team Mexico. Here's the 1-1 pitch from Ortiz. Off the plate, two balls and one strike. Tuma Sasaki is on deck for Team Japan, the Asian Zone champion here at the Colt World Series. The 2-1 hit in the air toward right. Gutierrez over against the wall and crashes hard into the wall as he was chasing that fly ball as it was curling toward the foul line. He hit hard out there, and there's only about 3 feet from the foul line to the padded wall down the right field line. As the training staff is out to check on him, of course, concerned as he hit it almost full speed. Not much room to operate as you're trying to chase down those balls that are curling away, curving away from you, slicing away. And that was the case there. It wound up going foul. They continue to look at Gutierrez, Diego Gutierrez, the right fielder for Tijuana, Mexico. He's on his feet and jogging, and he's making sure all his body parts are working. He seems like he's okay. He's up and about out in right field. Kurenami will come back to the plate facing a 2-2 count. So everybody seems okay. Gutierrez back to his position in right field. Of course, if you're not aware of what took place last night, these games were delayed today. Originally, the schedule had us for 5 games, the biggest day of the weekend here, as this is Elimination Day. We've seen 3 teams, a team from Aroma Park, Greensboro, North Carolina, and Santa Monica, California, all eliminated here today. Ground ball towards short, Blankenson. Gloves, throws across for the first out. 6-3 on the putout. But last night, we had storms that rolled through starting about 6 o'clock. It was a big line of showers and thunderstorms with strong winds. It blew in from the northwest, from the St. Louis metro area down toward our location here in Williamson County. And they came through with strong winds at about 70 miles an hour, causing damage in several areas, knocking out the power in a big part of Marion and in Franklin County, which is the county to our north. A lot of tree damage. I sat right here in the booth and watched it as it rained hard, wind blew hard, but it knocked the power out here at the ballpark, and that caused games to be suspended for the night. Power didn't come on until late last night. There's a strike, 0-2 from Juan Ortiz. So that meant that Steve Miller and Rachel Stroud and the gang with Colt Baseball had to rearrange the schedules. And we started things with first pitch at 7 o'clock this morning, taken low. And that was to get the final 2 outs of the game between Tijuana, Mexico. No, I'm sorry, Rio Grande Valley, Texas, and Santa Monica. Took about 57 seconds to complete that game. And then immediately after that, we had Aroma Park in Greensboro. Greensboro beat Aroma Park 16-1. Then we had Marion's first appearance, and they beat Tijuana, Mexico 6-0. Follow that up with Paderborn beating Santa Monica 5-2. That was the previous game. And here we have Tijuana in Japan facing off. Coming up next in game 12 will feature Southern Illinois and Rio Grande Valley, Texas. Then we will have the nightcap tonight as get the ground out of Suzuki. 2 down.
So Fujita.
The shortstop comes to the plate. Curveball for a strike. And a beauty from Juan Ortiz. Two-three on the strikeout of Suzuki. Called strike number 2 from Ortiz to So Fujita. Toyonaga is on deck. He stands on the Banterra Bank on deck circle to our left. Japan in the dugout on third base side. Mexico, the dugout on the right side. Here is the 0-2 pitch. Outside corner, strike three. 1-2-3 goes Japan for the second time in the contest. And we are going to head to the bottom of the second, Tijuana, Mexico. Looking to score their first run here at the bottom of the second, coming up on the 2023 Colt World Series. As we head to the bottom of the second inning, it'll be Tijuana, Mexico that comes to the plate. It is going to be Montiel, the first baseman. Carlos leading things off here in the bottom of the second inning. He is hit right in the left shoulder on the first pitch from the Yoto Okanishi. One pitch and a runner on first. Diego Gutierrez, who just made the attempt and crashed into the wall in right field.
Number 15, Diego Gutierrez.
Gutierrez digs in from the right side. Outfield straight away. And he tried to lay down a bunt, tips it foul. Breeze comes and goes here at the ballpark. Right now, not much of a breeze. Then it'll pick up about 7 or 8 miles an hour. No balls and two strikes to the right fielder Gutierrez, Diego Gutierrez. With the runner at first, and Montiel, and he fouls this pitch off. Keeps the count 0-2. Is the 0-2 pitch. Outside corner just missed. Didn't get the call. Framed nicely by Toyonaga. He wanted the call. Just couldn't get it from the home plate umpire. One ball, two strikes. That's lifted foul. Just protecting the plate was Gutierrez. On deck is Jesus Olivares. That's a ground ball toward second. Flip to second for one on the first double play. 4-6-3 on the turn. Nice job. Two down. So now, Jesus Olivares. Base runner erased, two down. And Olivares at the plate. Curveball, high and tight. Misses, ball one. You still have time to come out and join us here at the ballpark. Appealed that check swing. So it's two balls and no strikes. A little bit high. Oh, they call a strike. Got the high strike there. Two balls and one strike. Here is the 2-1. And that's fouled off.
Please return all foul balls to the pony gentleman up on the concourse. They will give you a token for a free Culver's ice cream.
Curveball hung up there and slapped back into center field for a base hit. And that is the first hit for Team Mexico. Comes off the bat of Jesus Olivares. Oscar Torres will come to the plate now.
Now batting, the center fielder, number 6, Oscar Torres.
With a wide open stance from the left side of the batter's box, Oscar Torres faces Oyoto Okanishi. The pitch bunted, foul. With two down. Got to give credit to all the umpires that we've had here. And to Colt Pony Baseball, Protect Our Nation's Youth, the league, fouled off again. The coordination that's taken place, especially this year, with the heat we had to deal with on Friday and Saturday, the storms last night. And can't say enough about Steve Miller and his staff, Rachel Stroud, everybody associated with it. His foul ball was pushed foul again. There are so many moving parts to putting on a tournament like this, especially when you have teams that are here from international countries, Germany, Japan, Mexico. One thing we haven't really talked a whole lot about, the Dominican Republic for the second year qualified for this Colt World Series, but because of some travel issues, they couldn't make it here. Then you have teams coming from points, the West Coast in Santa Monica, California, Greensboro, North Carolina, Aroma Park, now also from Texas, Rio Grande Valley, Texas. Runner takes off for second. The throw is thrown into center field. The runner is Olivares, who winds up at third. On the bat, the throw into center field by the catcher, Toyonaga, trying to gun down Olivares. Good hustle shown by Olivares to get into third base. So now he's in scoring position for Torres. So you never know what can happen here. We have no score. Ball's fouled off again. Mexico has two hits in the game. A single by Atondo and a single by Olivares. That one's in the dirt. Blocked nicely by Asuki Toyonaga. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. Bottom of the second inning with a runner at third. And the pitch. Called, third strike, got him looking to end the inning. Good pitching there by Hayato Okanishi. And that ends the threat and the bottom of the second inning. Chiba Japan is coming to the plate for the top of the third. They're coming up next here at your 2023 Colt League World Series. Here we are, top of the third inning for Chiba Japan. And it is the catcher, Asuki Toyonaga, to lead things off. Ferrugian will be next. And then Inouye will hit third. And if anybody gets on, top of the order we go to Tanaka. On the mound still for Tijuana, Mexico, Juan Ortiz. Two balls and one strike. Team Japan was the last team to arrive here at the ballpark, and they came in Friday morning. They arrived in Southern Illinois at 3 in the morning and was told that they were ready to play. They would have played at 6 o'clock had there been a game scheduled for them at 6 o'clock in the morning. Fortunately for them, they didn't play until noon, and they were beat by this Tijuana, Mexico team, 6-0. This is the second matchup of these two teams. Ground ball to second, and is Oviedo to retire Toyonaga. 4-3 for the first out. Here comes the center fielder for Chiba Japan.
Now batting, center fielder, number 8, Yonosuke Fujin.
Yonosuke Fujin at the plate. He bats for the first time here. And called strike one. 77 mile an hour pitch for Juan Ortiz. Here is the 0-1. Ground ball, base hit up the third baseline. Using the speed, making a big turn, pulls up and has to return to first base. So a long single, but a hard hit ground ball by Fujin. A single. And that is the first hit for Japan in this game. Yoda Inoue. He comes to the plate. Uno Inoue, however you say it. Hopefully we get it right. Here's the pitch. Runner takes off for second, slides in, and got his hand back on as he overslid the base. Stolen base for Fujin. He reached down with the left hand to grab the base as he was sliding by. That hand came off, but he reached around the tag with the right hand to get back on and stay safe. Good base running there by Fujin. Inoue at the plate, the third baseman. The pitch, bunted foul. He had everybody charging. Ballesteros coming in from third. Montiel coming in from first. And the catcher, Atondo, jumping out from behind the plate. Just couldn't drop it down into fair territory. So they'll reload. Runner Fujin back at second base. It's a very good fundamental team from Chiba, Japan. They've been a lot of fun to watch. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a foul ball. Count now 1-2. Ortiz from the stretch. Spins, forces the runner. Fujin back to the bag at second. It's kind of cool seeing all the kids here watching the ball games. If they wear their jerseys, they get into these games free. See a lot of them around the concourse. Swing and a miss. Drop third strike. They throw down, complete the strikeout. And smartly, Fujin heads to third. So two down. Fujin in scoring position and now top of the order to Fuma Tanaka. Tanaka flew out to right field to start this game. So 0-for-1, bats from the left side. With two outs, runner at third, scoring position. Outfield straight away, ground ball right side, fielded by Oviedo. Throws it to his first baseman, Montiel. They get out of the inning, 4-3 on the putout. Heading to the bottom of the third, now Tijuana, Mexico. Coming to bat next here at your 2023 Colt League World Series. top of the order for Tijuana, Mexico here. As Oviedo lays down the bunt down the third base line, and it was grabbed foul by Inouye. So just a strike. Here we are. No ball, no score. Japan with one hit. They've committed two errors here early in the game. Mexico has two hits. And again, this is a rematch of a game between these two teams on Friday. Tijuana, Mexico won 6-0. Chiba Japan is probably feeling the effects of their travel to the States. While the welcome meetings were taking place Thursday night, as the pitch is outside for a ball, one ball, two strikes. All the teams were here except for Japan, and they were in San Francisco waiting on their flight to St. Louis. Also, I have to give a shout out. It's chop foul. Had a buddy send me a picture last night that the St. Louis Airport, St. Louis International Airport, posted on their Twitter and their Facebook page of Paderborn, Germany. The team here at the Colt World Series, as they came through the airport, that was nice to see from the Facebook and Twitter, as the strikeout is recorded by Okanishi on Oviedo. And that is the first out here in the third inning. Arturo Blankenson, the shortstop, who reached on an error his first time up. He comes to the plate now with nobody on, one down in the third inning. And Hayato Okanishi continues to throw for Chiba Japan. Curveball just hung out there, and Blankenson went after it, couldn't catch up to it. Not that it was fast. It was a slow curve from Okanishi. One ball, one strike, one out. That's a fastball that's driven back into the right field for a base hit. Good hitting from Blankenson. So now it'll be Abraham Favela. He's the designated hitter here this afternoon for Tijuana, Mexico. Favela caught the first game today. Favela bats from the right side. He popped out to center his first time up. And that was the second out of the first inning. Curve ball in for a strike from Okanishi. Curveball hung out, drilled down the right field line, and it is curving foul. Similar to the fly ball that we saw Gutierrez go after down in the corner in right field. And Tanaka was right there to watch it go foul. So just a long strike, no balls and two strikes with one down, the runner at first in Blankenson. Popped up, right side. Is there enough room? Toyonaga comes over and watches it hit the roof above the seating here. And will it drop down? It does. Nobody can catch it. But they can turn it in for a custard from Culver's Restaurant, just across the way here from the ballpark, which sounds awesome. Pitches outside, throw down, and they get the runner at second in Blankenson. He says they missed the tag, but the umpire says no, they didn't. Good throw from Toyonaga and the tag from Fujita. 2-6 on the putout, so there's two down. Favela still at the plate, and he's facing a one ball, two strike count. Center fielder, Fujian, is camped out about as deep as you can play here at the ballpark. Wants to keep everything in front of him. Literally only has, it looks like, about 10, 12 feet behind him to the warning track. And it's 400 to straightaway center field. So he's probably at about 370. Chopper foul up the third base line. So here comes the 2-2 pitch with two outs. Curveball, one hopper towards short. Fujita to first in time, ends the inning. So after a single from Blankenson, throwing him out at second on the steal attempt, Chapin gets out of it, 1-2-3. Chiba Chapin coming to the bat, coming to the plate here in the fourth inning. No score from Marion, Illinois. Top of the fourth inning here at the ballpark at Throwville. No score between Chiba Chapin and Tijuana, Mexico. It's the fourth inning, and leading off for Japan,
Rinosuke Kanatani.
Kanatani leads things off. Rinosuke, he is 0 for 1. He grounded out the pitcher, his first time up, squares to bunt and takes a pitch for called strike. No runs, one hit for Japan. They've committed two errors. No runs, three hits. No errors for Mexico. Fastball, strike. 77 from Juan Ortiz, who so far has thrown 37 pitches for Tijuana, Mexico. Just south of San Diego, on the other side of the border. The Mexico zone champion. That's Slapped foul and out of play. No balls and two strikes. Pony Baseball, protect our nation's youth. Founded back in 1951 and quickly grew across the country. No balls, two strikes. The pitch from Ortiz, curve ball right back up the middle. Coming over is Blankenson, fields and throws and guns down. Kanatani for out number one. And that's going to bring up Ro Matsumoto. Matsumoto flew out to right field to end the first inning. And he bats here in the fourth with nobody aboard. From the left side of the box. And the plate takes the first pitch for ball one. So the winner will play tomorrow at 2 o'clock. Ground ball to second. Retires Matsumoto. 4-3 on the put out. And now it's going to be Toronosuke Koronami. He grounded out to short his first time up. With two down, still nobody aboard. Curve ball taken low for ball one. That one's lifted foul down the right side onto the concourse here at the ballpark. One ball, one strike, two out. Swing and a miss, one and two. He went after that pitch. Thought that was right in his wheelhouse. As a matter of fact, he went down to one knee as he was swinging at that one. Koronami looking at a 1-2 pitch from Juan Ortiz. Misses high and away. Evens it up 2-2. Both teams are up on the rail on their dugouts. Japan to the left, Germany to the right. Mexico to the right. So here's the 2-2 pitch. Curveball. Missed inside. Runs the count full now as Ortiz takes a little stroll, adjusts the ball cap. Steps back up on the rubber here at the ballpark at Thrillville. Comes set. Works from the stretch. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Missed high and walked him. So a base runner aboard now for Chiba Japan. Tuma Sasaki. Sasaki struck out and was thrown out after the dropped third strike by the catcher Atondo. And he has a runner aboard in front of him now in Koronami. Koronami thought about going. Returns to first base. Swing and a miss. Ball, no balls and one strike. Here is a ball. Evens the count 1-1. From Ortiz, the 1-1 pitch. Slow curve. It's a little bit low. 2-1. Here's the 2-1, a little bit low, 3-1. Some trades have taken place in Major League Baseball. Jordan Montgomery, the Cardinals, to the Texas Rangers. Jordan Hicks from the Cardinals to the Blue Jays as the pitch misses away, and that's a walk for Tuma Sasaki. Two aboard now here for Chiba Japan. Kurenami at second, Sasaki at first, and now shortstop So Fujita comes to the plate. He struck out his first time up. And Mexico wants to talk about it. Are they going to make a pitching change? No change in the pitcher. Ortiz will stay in the game. So far, he's thrown 52 pitches. Tijuana, Mexico team, the second game they played today. They were beat by Marion 6-0. Nix pitched an outstanding game. Ground ball right back up the middle, base hit. Here comes the runner around third. Kurenami, is he going to score? Throw is offline. He does. And I'm afraid he may have hurt his shoulder as he slid headfirst into home plate. And he is holding his left shoulder. And he came sliding in. The throw came up the first base line. He thought it was going to be closer to that, and so he slides head first. And as soon as he hit the ground, you could tell that he was grabbing toward his left shoulder. So he was safe. Japan takes the lead 1-0. Sasaki is the base runner at second. So Fujita picks up the RBI. The training staff is out looking at Kurenami as he is kneeling right at the home plate area. Japan quickly sends a couple of players to the bullpen in right center field. And getting up and walking back, Jornosuke Kurenami. Seems like he's okay. Really thought maybe he'd popped that left shoulder out of joint as he's walking back to the dugout. Toyonaga, the catcher, comes to the plate here as Japan has grabbed the 1-0 lead. We're in the top of the fourth inning with two outs, runners at first and second, and Asuki Toyonaga, the catcher, who grounded out to second. And that was back in the third inning. He bats here in the fourth. So Japan has sent Six players to the plate here so far. And two balls and no strikes to the catcher. Ball is grounded foul. Two balls and one strike now. Sasaki the runner at second. Fujita the runner at first. Toyonaga the batter. The two ball. One strike. Slow curve taken for a strike, two and two. Two balls, two strikes, two out, two on. Ortiz from the stretch comes set at the belt. The pitch, swing and a miss, struck him out. And that ends the inning, but Japan scores one run here in the top of the fourth inning. They lead it 1-0 here at your 2023 Colt League World Series. Japan took the lead there in the top of the fourth inning. We bat here in the bottom of the fourth with Tijuana, Mexico. It's the catcher, Eric Atondo. Atondo singled. He's got one of the three hits for Mexico. Bats from the right side. Here in the bottom of the fourth, he promptly laces this one into center field, drops in for a base hit. Didn't waste any time. Single for Atondo, and now it'll be the third baseman, Santiago Ballesteros, as he comes to the plate. One run on two hits, two errors by Japan. No runs, four hits for Tijuana, Mexico. Mexico beat this Chiba Japan team on Friday night, 6-0. So Japan would like to a avenge that first game loss they had after they had traveled around the world to make it here to the tournament. Drops the bunt down. It's a good one. Up the third baseline. Fielded. Throw in time to get the runner at first, but the sacrifice is good. Nice job by Inouye to get the ball to gun down the runner at first. 5-3 on the putout for the first out. But Atondo does wind up at second, so the sacrifice is successful. And Mexico has a runner in scoring position. It's going to be the first baseman, Carlos Montiel. Montiel bats from the right side. He pitched in the game earlier for Mexico. He was the starter. Okanishi continues to throw for Japan as he hangs one out there, and Montiel just drives it foul down the third base line. So he digs back in. He was hit by a pitch and erased on a 4-6-3 double play. The pitch, curveball, a little bit low. Gets away from the catcher, but not far enough for Atondo to advance on to third. Montiel is the batter. Gutierrez is on deck, the right fielder. Here's the pitch. Oh, that's a hard hit ground ball at third. Eight up the third baseman. He recovers, gets the throw off, and Inouye knocked it down. Went off his glove, hit him in the chest, and bounced away from him. He tried to get the runner at first, but just was a touch late on the throw. So we'll call that a base hit for Montiel. Ballesteros winds up at third base. So first and third with one down now. This is the first time that Okanishi's really been in trouble. I say that, and I look back at the score sheet, and Mexico has had runners at third on two occasions in the game. But both times, one of those times was with two down. So Hayato Okanishi, the right-hander, looks in. Gutierrez, who crashed into the wall a couple of innings back. And he seems to be okay. Comes to the plate now. Runners at the corners with one down. Hits this line drive into right field. Tanaka's there. Makes the catch. Bobbled it. They say he was taking the ball out of his glove when he dropped it. The run scores from third. So it's F9 on the putout. And it's a sacrifice RBI by Gutierrez as he gets the runner Atondo home. The runner at first in Montiel was not able to advance. Two down. We have a tie ball game, 1-1. We are in the bottom of the fourth inning. Pitch called strike. 78 mile an hour fastball from Hayato Okanishi. Okanishi's done a good job. He's only allowed 5 hits. He's thrown 57 pitches. That one's a little bit low. 2 balls and 1 strike. Curveball, driven into left field, base hits. looped it over the third baseman's head to throw to third to get the runner. He's safe. It was close. A good throw from Koronami in left. And so once again, it is going to be runners at the corners for Tijuana, Mexico. Good slide for Montiel as he went into third base head first. But Koronami was right on the ball in a good throw. And a good tag put down by Inouye, but they just missed him by a fraction. And so now the number nine hitter, Oscar Torres, has a great RBI opportunity and a chance to give Mexico the lead. Hit, foul, down the left field line, and it goes into the onto the roof here at the ballpark. It'll drop down, and there's several people there and several kids that have an opportunity at a free custard from Culver's if it drops all the way down. It does. Who's going to get it? Number two is getting a custard. How about that? An ice cream. Ball high, throw down, not in time. Runner scores from third. Olivares picks up the stolen base at second, and on the throw to second, Montiel comes in to score, and Tijuana, Mexico now leads it 2-1. Shortstop Fujita was cutting across the bag at second. He was going to try to make the throw home, and he bobbled the ball, and that allowed Montiel to score from third. So now it's 2-1. Team Mexico. Outfield shading to the right for Torres. Takes a pitch for ball three. Three balls, one strike. Very entertaining game here. Nobody scored the first three innings. Japan scored one, top of the fourth. Mexico scored twice here in the bottom of the fourth. The pitch lifted toward left. Koronami camps under it. Shades on, makes the catch. But Mexico scores twice to take the lead. And they lead Chiba Japan 2-1 as we head to the top of the fifth inning here at your 2023 Colt League World Series. Thank you. Chiba Japan, who had the lead for just a half inning, trails Tijuana, Mexico 2-1 here in the top of the fifth inning. It'll be the 8 and 9 hitters to lead things off. Ground ball towards short. Blankenson gloves and throws out. Fujian, 6-3 on the putout for the first out. It's going to bring up Yoda Inoue.
Now batting, the third baseman, number 15, Yota Inu.
Juan Ortiz continues for Tijuana, Mexico. He's only thrown 59 pitches here as we are in the top of the fifth inning. The right-hander deals, and the bunt attempt is missed for a strike by Inouye, the third baseman. Outfield, playing straightaway and shallow. Third baseman Yoda Inoue likes to utilize that speed. And he'll square around to bunt at any time. He's looking at a 1-1 pitch from Ortiz. And that is fouled off. I think that may have caught a little bit of the catcher, Atondo. One ball, two strikes, with one out. Curveball. If he doesn't hit that ball, it hits him right in his belly button. And he even nods his head toward the Mexico dugout. He'd have had a belly button piercing with that one. But he pulls it foul. It's 1-2. With one out, nobody on. Ortiz pitch. Grounded toward first. First baseman gets over, uses his speed, Montiel, to retire Inouye. 3-0 unassisted. Two down, top of the order now for Japan. And Fuma Tanaka is flowing out to right. He's grounded out to second. 0-2 in the game. Tanaka hitting .375 in the tournament. He's got 3 hits and 8 appearances at the plate. 2 singles, a double, 3 RBIs. He scored twice. Pitch called strike. 1 ball, 2 strikes now for Tanaka. Curveball, strike 3. Got him. Nope, it's just strike 2. I'm sorry. 1 ball, 2 strikes. There's 2 down here in this top of the fifth inning. The pitch. Swing and a miss. Got him that time. He was trying to protect the plate, and it was too close to let it go. So 3 up, 3 down, and Juan Ortiz retires the side. We are going to head to the bottom of the fifth inning now, and Tijuana, Mexico enjoys that 2-1 lead over Chiba Japan here at the Colt World Series. Thank you. bottom of the fifth inning. And at the plate, pinch hitter, Isaac Aguiar. Aguilar hitting for Gustavo Oviedo. Pops this one up on the left side. Noye is there, drops the ball. Drops it as it hits right on his glove. I don't know if the sun bothered him. That'll be E5. For Aguilar. Blankenson will come to the plate now.
Pitch running at first base. Number one, Dominic Fernandez.
Bunt, throw down the third baseline. Good job by Inouye to get over to get that, to retire. Blankenson, who picks up the sacrifice. He moves the runner, Aguilar, to second. 5-3 on the putout from one, the first out. And now it'll be Abraham Favela, the designated hitter. Favela in the game, flown out to center. He's grounded out to short. And he bats here with a runner in scoring position. We're in the bottom of the fifth inning. Curveball, strike one. Yodo Okanishi. Oh, excuse me, we have a new pitcher. Zingaki. Kosuke Zingaki. Zingaki, the right-hander, on relief for Okanishi. That's a curve that misses. To wrap up Okanishi, he threw four innings, allowed six hits, two runs, both of those earned. Didn't walk anyone, and he struck out two. Swing and a miss and struck out. Favela for out number two. And that's going to bring Atondo to the plate.
The catcher, number 19, Eric Atondo.
Atondo here in the tournament. He's hitting .500. 2-for-4. Officially, curveball hammered toward left, and it's going to drop in for a base hit. Oh, nice job by the left fielder to get the ball. But the runner scores from second in Aguilar, and Tijuana, Mexico has taken a 3-1 lead here. Base hit for Atondo. And now it'll be third baseman Ballesteros. Ballesteros hitting .167, officially 1-for-6 in the tournament with one single. He does have two RBIs, and he's walked once. So we have a courtesy runner coming on for Atondo.
Now courtesy running at first base, number 16, Luis Duenas.
Luis Duenas, the courtesy runner at first.
Now batting, third baseman, number 12, Santiago Ballesteros.
Ballesteros here today, grounded out, sacrificed his last time up in the fourth inning. And now he comes to the plate. It's this toward the gap in left center field. Drops for a base hit. Duenas rounds second on his way to third. Slides into third. Runners at the corner. And Tijuana, Mexico has found something here in the bottom of the fifth inning. And a single from Ballesteros. As Senkaki is in trouble. He's thrown 13 pitches.
The first baseman, number 8, Carlos Montiel.
Montiel in the game. Comes to the plate. He's hitting 330. Excuse me. He's 0-4-2 officially. But a great opportunity here with two outs. Runners at the corners. Duenas, the runner at third. Duarte, the runner at first. They set up outside, and he doesn't chase. Runs the count 1-1. 1-1. Senkaki needs an out. Throws it low, 2-1. Curveball, swing, and a miss. That was a good pitch. Big curve from Senkaki. Montiel went after it. Montiel. Looking at a 2-2 count. Oh, the runner took off. They're going to try and score the runner from third. Nice job by Duarte getting the attention. They throw back behind him, and they throw out the runner at third. What a good defensive play. That was designed to try to score that runner from third with two outs. And an outstanding play to gun down Duarte, the runner at third. So it went 1-3-5 on the putout. And Montiel will be at the plate when he comes back in the sixth inning. One run across, 3-1 the score. Mexico with the lead over Japan here at the 2023 Colt League World Series. Top of the sixth inning, and Japan needs some runs. They trail this game 3-1.
Leading off the top half of the sixth inning, the team of Japan.
This is a rematch from a Friday night game in which Mexico won 6-0. So, Munasaki Kanatani comes to the plate to lead things off, and he fouls this pitch off to the right. One run on two hits, three errors committed by Japan. Three runs on eight hits, no errors by Mexico. The loser of this game is done for the tournament, as this is elimination day here at the ballpark. The winner advances to play tomorrow at 2 o'clock. So here is the 1-1 pitch from Juan Ortiz. Ground ball, left side, foul. One ball, two strikes. With nobody out. Curve ball, base hit. Into center field for Kanatani to start things off here in the top of the sixth inning. So that's going to bring Ro Matsumoto to the plate.
Now batting, the designated hitter, number 13, Ro Matsumoto.
Matsumoto in the tournament. Hitting .333, he is 2-for-6. Here in the tournament. Two singles, has an RBI, he scored a run. He's walked once, struck out once. Here's the 1-0 pitch from Ortiz. Outside corner for strike. Evens the count, one ball, one strike. Runner at first. And Kanatani just misses outside, two balls and one strike. Curveball outside corner for strike two. Breeze blowing from the north toward the right field corner. Matsumoto at the plate. Checked his swing, and they say it was outside for a ball. It was close. Ortiz, I think he stepped on his sunglasses. Takes him over to his dugout after picking him up off the pitching mound. So three balls, two strikes with nobody out. Runner at first in Kanatani. Japan needs a couple of runs. They trail it 3-1. getting late into this game, top of the sixth inning. Winner advances, loser goes home. Curve ball popped, foul. Left side onto the roof. So staying alive is Matsumoto. To Norisuke Koronami is on deck. With the full count, runner at first, nobody out. The pitch from Juan Ortiz from the stretch. Hit toward the gap in right center field. That's going to get down and go all the way to the wall. The runner at first in Kanatani scores all the way from first, and that's a triple for Matsumoto. Big time hit in a clutch situation, and it cuts the lead down to one. Japan trails by one, and that may be it for Juan Ortiz. A slow stroll by the manager out to the mound. And that is going to be it for Juan Ortiz. What a good ball game Ortiz has pitched. He leaves with a 3-2 lead. And he gets a handshake from his teammates as he walks off the field. Ortiz went five innings, allowed four hits, two runs, both of them earned, walked two, struck out five. Just an outstanding ball game by Juan Ortiz. Luis Duenas will come in to relieve Ortiz. Let him throw some warm-ups. We'll be back. So the new pitcher for Tijuana, Mexico, Luis Duenas. So a pinch hitter is going to be Ayumu. Ayumu Ono pinch hitting for Koronami here with a runner at third base, just 90 feet away. The infield playing way in defensively. They want to cut down that runner, and there's nobody out. That was a big-time triple by Matsumoto. And he is the runner at third base. Could be the tying run. This has turned in and been an outstanding game. Really well played by both teams. We've seen some good defense, good pitching on both sides. And the pitch misses outside, evens the count, one ball, one strike. Luis Duenos is the new pitcher for Mexico. Infield drawn in. Ono, the batter at the plate from the left side. Up on top of the plate, here's the pitch. Ground ball, gets it to second, looks the runner back, gets the out at first. So good job. That's the first out. Infield will stay in here. They may back up and, no, they'll play in. So now it'll be Choma Sasaki, the first baseman. Sasaki in this tournament. It's a 400 hitter. Two hits in five official at-bats. And the pitch called strike on the outside corner. Sasaki has a single, a triple, two RBIs. He scored two. He's walked once. Takes the pitch for strike two. So the runner, Matsumoto, is 90 feet away. Here's the 0-2 from Duenas. Swing and a miss, struck him out. That is a big strikeout for Duenas. Still a one-run lead, 3-2. Infield will back up now to normal depth. As So Fujita, the shortstop, comes to the plate.
So Fujita.
Fujita hitting 200. He has one hit in five official at-bats, seven plate appearances. And that one hit was a single. So two outs here in the top of the sixth inning. Winner advances, loser will make a long trip home. Here's the pitch. Hit foul and out of play. Evens the count 1-1. So Fujita today struck out back in the second, singled in the fourth, had an RBI. That scored Koronami. Here's the 1-1 pitch with two outs. Down low for a ball, two balls and one strike. Coming up, the next game. Will be Southern Illinois against Rio Grande Valley, Texas. Still two more games here this evening at the ballpark. I just want to make sure I'm not forgetting a game. I am correct. It's been a long day. We started at 7 o'clock this morning to finish a game that took 57 seconds for the final two outs. Thank you. Pitch taken up high. So, three balls, one strike. In the dirt, walked him. Runners at the corners now. Fujita walks. and Asuki Toyonaga. Comes to the plate. Toyonaga in the tournament.
Now batting, the catcher, number 12, Asuki Toyonaga.
A 500 hitter, two hits, four official at bats. He's made six appearances at the plate. He's got a triple and a single. As there's a conversation taking place by Atondo and Duenas. So everybody's ready. One ball, no strikes. Toyonaga at the plate. They check the runner at third. Matsumoto, the runner at third. Fujita, the runner at first, with two down. Base hit ties the game. A gapper could give Japan the lead. The pitch from Duenas. They throw a pitch out. Nobody's moving. And now the count 2-0. Duenas comes set. Up high, 3-0. Here's the pitch. Off goes the runner from first. Strike. So two runners in scoring position now. Fujita winds up at second. Catcher in difference. He had a big lead. It started for second before the ball was even released. 3-1 count with two outs, two on. Toyonaga, the batter at the plate. Here's the pitch. Ball four. Bases are loaded. And we're going to have a possible pitching change here. No pitching chains, just a strategy talk. Bases are loaded for Japan. Matsumoto, the runner at third. Fujita at second. Toyonaga at first and at the plate. Fujian. He singled. And he's grounded out. Japan needs a run to tie. Threatening here in the top of the sixth. Here's the pitch. Taken for a strike. One ball, one strike. Luis Duenas. He's thrown 17 pitches now. Fujian at the plate. The 1-1. Popped him up. Right side. Is it playable? Coming over is Mont. Tiao makes the catch, and that ends the threat, ends the inning. And with bases loaded, Japan leaves them full. And we are heading to the bottom of the sixth inning here. Mexico leads 3-2. Bottom of the sixth inning here for Mexico as they come to the plate. They lead it 3-2. And it is going to be Carlos Montiel who just made that catch in foul territory to end the threat in the top of the sixth inning. Looks at a pitch low. Evens the count, 1-1. Three, two is our score. There's another pitch low for 2-1. Japan has 2 runs on 4 hits, 3 errors, 3 runs on 8 hits for Mexico. They've not committed an error. And the pitch. Swing and a miss, evens the count 2-2. Kosuke Sengake continues to pitch for Team Japan. He's up to 21 pitches. Here is the 2-2. Fouled off, cued off the end of the bat. Five o'clock Central Time. Here on a Sunday evening, still 2 more games to go. It will be Southern Illinois taking on Rio Grande Valley, Texas. That's the next game. And then the nightcap tonight will be Youngstown, Ohio against Marion. Here is the 2-2 pitch. Curveball hung up, fouled out of play. Hits on the roof to our left. Tomorrow, the winner of this game will play tomorrow at 2 o'clock. The loser is done for the tournament. So there's an 8 o'clock game tomorrow. No, excuse me, an 11 o'clock, a 2 o'clock, a 5 o'clock, and then an 8 o'clock game. That's the semifinal rounds. And Championship Tuesday will take place. Possibility of 3 games on Tuesday. It depends on how things shake out. Call called. Third strike as Montiel is down on strikes. One down, and Diego Gutierrez comes to the plate. Gutierrez in the tournament. No hits in two official plate appearances. Coming into this game, he's 0 for 2. Hit into a 4-6-3 double play. Back in the second, popped out to right. It was a sacrifice, picks up the RBI. That pitch caught the catcher, Asuki Toyonaga. So 3-2 is our score. Mexico holding on to a one-run lead. They'd like to extend that as we head to the seventh inning. Senkaki's pitch taken outside. One ball, two strikes. Now two balls, two strikes. And a new pitcher coming in for Japan. New pitcher is Yota Takada for Japan. He comes in with two down, 2-2 pitch, and struck him out. One pitch, that was a big pitch right there. Back-to-back strikeouts for Tijuana, Mexico. And now it is Jesus Olivares. Jesus in the game is singled twice. He's been stranded twice. So Takada throws strike one. Here's the pitch from Takada. Swing and a miss, strike two. Nobody on. There's two outs in a 3-2 ball game. Mexico leads it 3-2. Popped up out of play to the right. Here is the pitch, popped in the air toward right, calling for it. Is Tanaka makes the catch. Three up, three down. And we are heading to the seventh inning. Japan must score if they want to continue to play here in this tournament. They need one to tie and two to take the lead. Top of the seventh we go. Mexico leads it 3-2. So here we are, top of the seventh for Japan. They need one run to tie this game. And a strike from Luis Duenos. The pitch, grounded on the right side. First baseman dives, flips it, and save! What a base running dive by Inouye as he got the hand on before the pitcher could get there. A diving stop by the first baseman Montiel, and Duenos came over to cover, but diving head first was Inouye. So a base hit to start things off for Japan, and the right fielder, Fuma Tanaka, comes to the plate. Tanaka in this tournament .375 hitter, square showing bunt. In at third is Ballesteros. This has been a really good, fun ball game. 3-2. We're in the top of the seventh. Last gasp here for Japan to tie it. Pitch called strike. 76 on the gun. One of the things you may not think about here, but the sun is right in the fielder's eyes on the right side. Second, first, right field. They're having to look right up in the setting sun here at the ballpark. They throw across to check on the runner, Inouye, and he gets in safely. Two runs on five hits for Japan now. Three runs on eight hits for Mexico. Tanaka shows bunt. They throw back over. He gets away from the first baseman. Runner to second and safely. So that is one of the perils of throwing and checking runners instead of just stepping off and looking him back. Inouye winds up at second. He's the tying run at second base. So now will Tanaka continue to show bunt? Bat on his left shoulder. Stares out at Duenos. Does not show bunt. Curveball hangs outside. Ball one. One ball, one strike. He bats from the left side. Gap in right center field is wide open. Left and center playing straight away. The pitch catches the outside corner with a strike. One ball, two strikes. The runner at second, Inouye. Inouye gets his lead. Here's the pitch. Chop, third base side. Look the runner back at second. Throw in time. And after the throw, the runner Inouye winds up at third anyway, so it'll go as a sacrifice for Tanaka. 5-3 on the putout. And here comes Kanatani, the second baseman. Kanatani batting 167. He's got one hit in six official at-bats. That one hit, though, a single, and the pitch taken for ball one. So the tying run just 90 feet away. Here's the pitch from Luis Duenos. Popped up right side, foul territory. Montiel goes over, gives it a look, and it's about four rows into the seats. And a free ice cream for the little guy making his way over to get it. Can I find it? Looking down. Oh, here comes another kid. I got to hurry up. I don't see it. There's still a chance for somebody to come get a free ice cream. One ball, one strike, one out. One on at third. Trailing by one. Japan, the pitch. Up high for a ball. Two balls and one strike. There are four kids looking for that foul ball. It's over, I promise. Timeout called by the batter. Kanatani. Digs back in now. They're shallow in the outfield. Driven toward the gap in right center field. It's a long way. It's going to go to the warning track. The tying run scores from third. In Inouye, we have a tie ball game, 3-3. And a RBI double by Kanatani ties this game here in the top of the seventh inning. And now it'll be Ro Matsumoto coming to the plate, the designated hitter. And an RBI opportunity for Ro.
Now batting, the designated hitter, number 13, Ro Matsumoto.
Ro, a 333 hitter. digs in. Duenos delivers, throws it away. Ball one. Kanatani, the runner at second. Here's the pitch. Away. Two balls and one strike. The winner of this game advances. We'll play it at 2 o'clock tomorrow. The loser goes home. Outside corner for a called strike. Evens the count, two balls and two strikes. We're tied 3-3 here in the top of the seventh inning. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. A little half-hearted swing strikes him out. And that is out number two. Duane has tied him up on that one. And so now, Onu. So this is Aruki Don. Aruki Don comes in to bat here. In the seventh, batting for Ono. No balls, one strike. Runner at second. That's the go-ahead run with two outs. Luis Duenos from the stretch. The pitch, curveball. Misses high, two balls, one strike. These two teams played on Friday. Mexico won 6-0. We're tied 3-3 here in the top of the seventh. Here's the pitch. Pop foul. Is it going to get out of play? It does. It heads toward the berm in left field in another life. For a Aruki Don. He turned on that one. On deck, first baseman Thomas Sasaki. So Don is at the plate. Runner at second, the go-ahead run with two outs, two balls, two strikes. Luis Duenos, the pitcher for Tijuana, Mexico, from the stretch. Ground ball fielded there by Ballesteros, throws across in time. And that is the third out here in the top of the seventh. So we are going to the bottom of the seventh. Tijuana, Mexico, a chance to win it here. And advance on in the 2023 Colt World Series. This is it. It comes down to the bottom of the seventh inning for Team Mexico. They are tying 3-3 after giving up the tying run in the top of the seventh to Chiba Japan. Yuta Takada trying to close out this game for Japan. Leading off, Oscar Torres at the plate. Torres fouls that off. He's 0-for-2 in the game, struck out in the second, flew out in the fourth. Bats here in the bottom of the seventh to lead things off. Outstanding ball game. 3 runs on 6 hits for Japan. They tied it in the top of the seventh. 3 runs on 8 hits for Mexico. They're trying to win it here in the bottom of the seventh. Japan scored 1 in the 4th, 1 in the 6th, 1 in the 7th. Mexico scored in the 4th and 1 in the 5th. That's where we're at, 3-3. Here's the pitch from Takada. Fouled it off his leg. Hops around for just a couple of minutes. That stings. Shake your leg one time. Shake the leg twice. Turn yourself around. Digs back into the play. Winner of this game advances. They'll play tomorrow. Loser will have a trip back home. So Japan was beat by this Mexico team on Friday, 6-0. Japan turned around and beat Aroma Park 23-0. So a double elimination tournament. Lose 2, and you're done. The pitch away for ball 3. Full count to Oscar Torres. Torres, the open stance. The 3-2 pitch. Ground ball right side. Sasaki has it. Steps on the bag himself at first. 3-U on the putout, 1 down and top of the order now for Tijuana, Mexico. Isaac Aguilar will be the batter. Aguilar came on.
Now batting, the second baseman, number 1, Dominic Hernandez.
Be actually Dominic Hernandez. Hernandez batting here in the seventh inning. From the right side, lifts it out toward shallow right field, coming in, calling for it, right fielder Tanaka. 2 down. And now it'll be Arturo Blankenson, the shortstop. Hitting 333, 2 hits and 6 at bats. Looks at the first pitch for a strike. On deck, Abraham Favela. 3-3 game with 2 outs, nobody aboard for Tijuana, Mexico. As we mentioned, the winner of this will advance to play at 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. The 1-1 pitch, curveball, thought he had it, fouled it off to the right. Here is the 1-2 pitch from Tancata in the dirt. 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs. Arturo Blankenson, the shortstop, reached on an error, singled, sacrifice fly, lifts this out of play. Actually, sacrificed in the fifth on a grounder to third. Nobody on. Giving the gaps in left center and right center. Pulled and protecting the lines. Grounded foul. Turned on that one. Here's the 2-2. Over the head and to the backstop. Runs the count full. So what does Yuta Takata do here? Stands both feet on the rubber. Looks in at his catcher, Yokonaga. Here's the pitch. Ground ball, third base. Grabbed by Inouye. Throw across in time. And we are going to extra innings. Top of the eighth is coming. We are tied at three. Winner advances. Loser going home here at your 2023 Colt League World Series. Extra innings here in this elimination game. Chiba Japan comes to bat here in the top of the eighth inning. It'll be the 5, 6, and 7 hitters. Toma Sasaki, So Fujita, and Asuki Toyonaga. And on the mound for Tijuana, Mexico, Luis Duenos. Duenos in the game. Misses inside. Ball one. One ball, one strike. Duenos has thrown 39 pitches after coming on to relieve Juan Ortiz, who pitched an outstanding game. Came in with left the game with a 3-1 lead. Can only win it. Can't can't lose it. Duenos has done a good job, though. We're tied 3-3 with one ball, two strike count. Nobody out, nobody on. Sasaki lines this towards center. Coming in a few steps and gliding to the right is Torres for the first out. One down, and so Fujita is the batter. Fujita.
Not bad. Shortstop, number two, so Fujita.
Hitting 400. Two hits, five appearances coming into this game. Takes the first pitch for ball one. He struck out, singled, and walked. Looks at strike one, evens the count, one ball, one strike. Outfield is straight away. Top of the eighth inning, extra innings here. In an important game. Curveball, strike two. You win and you stay, you play tomorrow. You lose. And your tournament for 23 is completed. One ball, one strike, one out. Line foul, out of play off the facade, and drops straight down to the seats to our right. Good crowd is here as Southern Illinois and Marion will be playing the next two games. One ball, two strikes with one out. Curveball, hammered out of play by Fujita.
Please return all foul balls to the pointy gentleman up on the concourse to receive your token for free Culver's ice cream.
One ball, two strikes. Fouled at the plate once again. Staying alive. Southern Illinois preparing to take on Rio Grande Valley, Texas. That'll be the next game. And then the nightcap tonight, Marion against, host team Marion against Youngstown, Ohio. Here's the 1-2. Hit down the line. Be careful, Gutierrez, as he goes toward the wall. That one went out of play. He was chasing a foul ball earlier in the game, Diego Gutierrez. And he waves back to his teammates in the dugout saying, I'm okay. But he ran almost full speed into the padding down the right field line. He's good now. One ball, two strikes, the pitch. Curveball. Hanging tight. Fouling it off is So Fujita. The pitch. Spoiled that one as well. Out of play. Keeps the count 1-2. This will be the ninth pitch of this at bat for Fujita. The 10th, actually. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. The off-speed pitch at 66 gets Fujita to strike out. Two down. Asuki Toyonaga.
Now batting, the catcher, number 12, Asuki Toyonaga.
Toyonaga in the game. Is grounded out, struck out, walked. 0 for 2 officially. And with two outs here in the top of the eighth inning, Japan needs a base runner, and it comes down to Toyonaga, the catcher. Luis Duenos, the pitcher. Hit down the line. It's going to find the seats over to the right. Up onto the ramp area. Rattles around up there. It'll come down the hill. And it's a race for ice cream. And we have a winner. As they wrestle around for the ball so they can get a custard. Here's the 0-2. Called third strike outside corner. And that retires the side. Three up, three down. Tijuana, Mexico. A chance to win this game in the bottom of the eighth inning here at the Colt World Series. This is the bottom of the eighth inning for Tijuana, Mexico. First pitch, hit to third, throw across in time to retire. Abraham Favela, 5-3 on the putout for one down. Mexico needs a run. One run would win it. They would advance to play. The loser of Youngstown, Ohio, and Marion. So now it's Eric Atondo at the plate. Atondo today has singled. He's doubled. Hits that one foul. Or lines it out to third, rather. So two up, two down quickly. Took my eye off the ball for just a second. And a catch made over there by third baseman, Yoda Inouye. So Santiago Ballesteros at the plate. Yuta Takata trying to keep Japan in this game. They want another chance to go hit in the top of the ninth inning. A game that started this afternoon. Forgot to write down the time, and that's going to be a little base hit in front of the left fielder, Kuranami. So keeps Mexico in this, the base hit. Carlos Montiel. Will bat with two outs. Montiel coming into the game. We're here today was hit by a pitch. He singled and scored, and then struck out his last time up. One runner on. 3-3 ball game. Big cut. And the pitch by Takata took something off that. And the count 0-1. Montiel, the first baseman. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Called strike. Strike two. Takata has thrown 29 pitches so far. Looks in. The right-hander stands on the third base side from the stretch. The 0-2. Outside corner misses. Pats the rosin bag on the back side of the mound with the right hand. Ball in his right hand. Looks in. The pitch. Hammered foul up the third base line. One ball, two strikes. Runner at first. Misses away. Evens the count, two balls and two strikes. Asuki Toyonaga framing that there for home plate umpire. Carlos Montiel trying to extend this inning with two outs. 2-2 pitch, one on. The runner goes. Hits it foul. And now, Ballesteros will have to return to first. On deck, Diego Gutierrez, the right fielder. Call throw over to check on the runner. And Ballesteros. Takata looks in. The 2-2 pitch. Throws it outside. And the count full now. For Mexico's Carlos Montiel. Carlos from the right side, the pitch. Missed away, walked him. So two on now for Mexico. A base hit could win it. David Diego Gutierrez will come to the plate for Tijuana, Mexico. In the tournament, coming into today's game, Gutierrez Gutierrez first time up in the second, grounded into a double play. Sacrificed in the fourth. Bats here in the eighth. Looks at one for a strike. Ballesteros, the runner at second. Montiel, the runner at third, at first. And Gutierrez at the plate. With two down, two aboard. The 0-1 in the dirt, blocked nicely by Toyonaga. One ball, two strikes. Takata. Inside corner for a strike. One ball, two strikes. Straight away in the outfield. Yuta, Takata from the stretch. Ground ball, left side, gets through, picked up by the shortstop. He has the runner off the bag at third, but he dives back in. And Mexico, that was a good backup play by Fujita at short. And Yoy couldn't get to the ball. And Fujita was right there behind him to pick it up. And the runner, Ballesteros, had made the turn at third and stopped suddenly. And it's a good thing he did. We had a game earlier this tournament. Paderborn, Germany lost the game after the third out. The runner overran third and was tagged out to end the game. Here is the pitch off the hands. And that's the force out, and it's going to keep the game alive. Little liner towards short, flip towards second to get Gutierrez. 6-4 on the putout. And we're heading to the ninth inning. Here between Tijuana, Mexico and Chiba, Japan, it is tied 3-3 with Japan coming to the plate. Center fielder Fujian coming to the plate for Chiba, Japan. We are still tied at three here in the top of the ninth inning.
For Japan, center fielder number eight.
Three runs on six hits for Japan. Grounded right back to the pitcher. Duenos has it. Underhand flip to first. 1-3 on the putout. So it'll be third baseman Yuta Inoue. Three runs on six hits for Japan. Three runs on 10 hits for Mexico. We're tied here at three. And the ball is bunted into the air, and nobody can get to it. Thought Ballesteros had the best chance. The winner of this game will advance on. The loser will be done for this 2023 tournament. The pitch, that's line foul it up toward the concourse. So no balls, two strikes with one out. Nobody aboard for Japan. Slap foul once again. Here's the 0-2. Just misses outside. Team Mexico fans thought that was there for a strike. Team Japan fans applauding because it was outside. Didn't miss by much. 1-2 now to the batter, Fujian, the center fielder. Missing low, two balls and two strikes now. Mentioned it earlier, the setting sun right directly in the eyes of the fielders on the right side. First baseman, second, right fielder. So anything in the air could be possible. The ball gets away from the catcher. 3-2. Full count to Fujian. The pitch misses away, walks him. Excuse me, did Noye gets the walk. And now top of the order, Fuma Tanaka will be the batter. Tanaka in the game is flown out, grounded out, struck out, sacrificed. Bats from the left side. Takes the first pitch off the plate for ball one. This is the top of the ninth inning. Each team with one win and one loss. Two losses knocks you out of the tournament. The pitch from Duenos. Looks in, holds the pitch. Grounder, left side, foul. Everybody returns to their position. We appreciate everybody watching our games here on YouTube. Great crowd set up for tonight's game. Here is the pitch from Duenos. Off the plate, misses. They throw behind the runner. And if he put the tag down, they would have had him. The first baseman, Montiel, I think lost track of him. Thought maybe he actually had taken off. But Inouye had backtracked and came back to the bag, dove in. So a break there for Japan. Keeping the runner at first with one down. Tanaka at the plate. Duenos on the mound. Swings and misses. The count now, two balls and two strikes. Japan scored one in the fourth, one in the sixth, one in the seventh. Mexico scored two in the fourth, one in the fifth. And that's where we're at. We're tied 3-3 here in the top of the ninth. Win and advance. Lose and you go home. The pitch off the plate. Called strike three. Striking out Tanaka for the second out of the inning. Two down. And now it'll be Runosaki Kanatani. Runosaki Kanatani has grounded out twice, singled, and doubled. With two down, Japan needs a run. Or they would like a run, not that they need it. We're tying 3-3. They're the visitors. So Mexico will come to the bat, come to the plate here in the bottom of the ninth. They throw across, checking on Inouye. Luis Duenos now has thrown 70 pitches. That one fouled straight back. Two strikes to Kanatani. They set up outside. Here's the 0-2. Steps off. Kanatani digs in on the right side. The runner Inouye takes his lead at first. Duenos comes set. Misses it outside. One ball and two strikes. Steps off again. One ball, two strikes. Center fielder Torres shading just a little bit toward left center for Kanatani. He's got a single to double today. Swings and misses, strikes out. And that ends the top of the ninth for Chiba Japan. Can Takata close it out and keep Japan in it? Mexico is coming to the bat, coming to the plate here in the bottom of the ninth with a chance to win it. Here's your 2023 Colt League World Series. Extra innings. We're in the bottom of the ninth now for the home team. Tijuana, Mexico, a chance to win it here in the bottom of the ninth. All tied at three, and it's the number nine hitter, Oscar Torres, that'll lead things off. Torres hits from the left side, and he has struck out, flown out, and grounded out. Looking for his first hit today, and tries to bunt. And a strike as he can't catch up to it. One ball, one strike. Yuta Takada continues to throw for Chiba Japan. He's done an outstanding job. He's up to 42 pitches. Right back up the middle. Base hit. And Oscar Torres has his first hit of the game. And it's going to be top of the order now. Dominic Hernandez scheduled to bat. It will be Hernandez. Hernandez came in the seventh and flew out to right field.
Now batting, the second baseman, number one, Dominic Hernandez.
Hernandez from the right side with a runner on, and Yuta Takada on the mound for Japan, trying to extend this game. Lays the bunt down the third baseline. It's a beauty. It goes foul. Boy, they caught Japan, caught a break there because I actually think Inouye tried to pick it up and missed it. It went between his legs and it curved foul. Maybe he just pulled off at the last second, hoping it was going to go foul, and it did. But nonetheless, that was a good bunt. But now Hernandez comes back to the plate. Runner at first in it. Torres. No balls, one strike. Grounder back to the pitcher. Looks to second, throws to first, sacrifices good for Hernandez. 1-3 on the putout for the first out. It does advance Torres, and now it's going to bring up Blankenson. Blankenson today reached on an error, has singled, grounded out twice to third, one time a sacrifice. That ball's lifted toward right. Going at, out, and making the catch is Tanaka. The runner at second tags up and heads to third. And so the game-winning run is just 90 feet away. With two down for Tijuana, Mexico, Abraham Favela will be coming to the plate. A chance to be the hero here and advance on to the next round, the semifinal rounds of this tournament. Win and you play tomorrow. Lose and you're traveling home tomorrow. With two outs, runner at third in Torres. Takada on the mound. He wants the out. Favela wants the hit. Hits it towards center. Drives the center fielder back. Makes the catch for the third out. And we are going to the 10th inning. Man, Favela got all of that one. He drove it to center field. And Funchen was there to make the catch. And we are going to the 10th inning. All tied 3-3 here at your 2023 Colt League World Series. 10th inning is where we're at. Top of the 10th, all tied at 3. Neither team wants to go home. Neither team wants to win it. Neither team wants to lose it. So now it's going to be Rowe. Matsumoto at the plates, facing Luis Duenos again. Hits this, it's going to drop in for a base hit. And the left field. Matsumoto, that is his second hit of the day. He singles to left. And now it'll be Toranosuke Koranami. No, I'm sorry. Aruki Don.
Re-entering the game for Chiba Japan.
No, it will be Koranami.
Toranosuke Koranami.
Toranosuke Koranami will re-enter in place of the Curry Dan. And he bats here in the top of the 10th with a runner on. Luis Duenos, who has thrown 74 pitches after coming in to relieve Juan Ortiz, who threw a great game, left the game with a 3-1 lead. But he gave up a couple base runners that scored. And a swing and a miss. Koranami. That was a big cut. Fans are into the game here at this Colt World Series. Hangs that one. Popped up right side. Right fielder Gutierrez is there for out number one. Did a good job handling that sun that is right in his eyes. And so now it'll be Toma Sasaki. Talma Sasaki hits from the left side. Still have the runner at first, Matsumoto. Duenos comes set, steps off. Steps off again. It's turned out to be a beautiful evening. Right now, still 87. It's going to be a good night for baseball. Still two more games to come here this evening to wrap up this day of play on Sunday. That's a strike. A bender from Duenos. And the count 0-1 to the first baseman, Toma Sasaki. Misses, they throw away, pitching out, thinking that the steal was on by Matsumoto. It was not. Evens the count now, 1-1. In a tie game, 3 runs, 7 hits for Japan, 3 runs, 11 hits for Mexico. Mexico beat this Japan team on Friday night, 6-0. Friday afternoon, actually, in a noon game. Japan had gotten into town at about 3 o'clock this in the morning. 1-2. Hit that foul. So Japan went on to beat Aroma Park the next day, 23-0. So they've got 1 win, 1 loss. Tijuana, Mexico, as we said, beat this Japan team 6-0. They lost to Marion this morning 6-0. This is their second game of the day. Chop foul again. So that explains why we're in a position. After your second loss, you are done, with the exception being the two teams that played this morning for the consolation game. Aroma Park and Greensboro, North Carolina. They had gotten beat in both of their first two games, and so they were guaranteed at least a third game. The ball gets away from the catcher, Atondo, and that is a big play as it puts Matsumoto down at second base in scoring position. There's some question whether it was bunted or did he go? Did he go around, and he did, and that's a strikeout. So the runner took second, but Sasaki strikes out. And now there's two outs, and that's going to bring So Fujita to the plate. Here today, Fujita has struck out, he's singled and has an RBI, he's walked, and he's struck out. His fifth appearance here in this game at the plate. He stands right on top of the home plate. No balls, one strike, two out, runner at second. Luis Duenos, the right-hander, trying to extend the game. Lines this toward right center field. It's going to find the gap. That is going to score the go-ahead run for Japan. And Japan leads this game 4-3 on the RBI base hit by So Fujita. Four to three is our score. So the single for Fujita drives in the go-ahead run. Matsumoto scores from second to give Japan the 4-3 lead. How does Luis Duenos respond to that? That pitch hit foul by Asuki Toyonaga. Toyonaga is grounded out, struck out, walked, struck out. One run scored by Japan in the fourth, one in the sixth, one in the seventh, and one in the tenth to take the 4-3 lead here. Mexico scored two in the fourth, one in the fifth. They've not scored since. It's a 4-3 lead for Chiba Japan. This has been just an outstanding ball game. Good pitching, timely hitting, good defense. Just as it should be. That went in the dirt for a ball. They say it went around. Strike two. No balls and two strikes with two outs. And the runner at first. In Fujita. Duenos. His pitch up high. That's the first ball to Toyonaga. One ball, two strikes. Hit toward the hole in right. So back-to-back hits now for Team Japan. Runners at first and second, and it's going to bring Fujian here to the plate with two down. Got to be some tired players out here on the field. It's 87 degrees. It's probably 95, maybe 100 on that turf, and they've been out there for a while this afternoon. And this is the second game. So two on with two outs. Fujian at the plate. Looks away, ball one. So Fujita with the go-ahead RBI. He's the runner at second. Takes his lead. They come in behind him, and he gets back on the bag. Fujita at second. Toyonaga at first. The pitch. Inside, almost hitting. The 2-0 pitch. Tueno steps off. Fujita at second base dancing around out there got his attention. Blankenson, the shortstop, staying close, would like to sneak in behind him. The pitch away. 3-0. Duenos, after giving up the go-ahead run on the base hit by Fujita, has allowed Fujita and Toyonaga to reach base. Here's the pitch. Up high, walked him, ball four, bases loaded. Noye, who has struck out, ground out, singled, and walked. That may be it for Luis Duenos, who has thrown 92 pitches. Gets a hug from his teammates. He was outstanding. Let's go to the box score and see what he did here. Through four, and let's back up and talk about Juan Ortiz. Ortiz threw five innings, allowed four hits, two runs, two earned. He walked two, struck out five. Duenos comes in relief. He allowed five hits, just two runs. Walked four, struck out seven. Combined, that's a pretty good line. But we have a new pitcher now for Tijuana, Mexico. We'll give you the details coming up. Oscar Torres is the new pitcher to come in play and replace Luis Duenos. Duenos threw 92 pitches. Outstanding pitching performance by Tijuana, Mexico. But here we are. It's Oscar Torres that has his hands full. He's got bases loaded. With two outs, throws the first pitch off the plate for ball one. Yuta. Inu is the batter. Yuta Inu. Pops it up behind the plate. Coming back, Atondo gives chase, and it's into the seats. That little chop swing of Inu. And he's even in the count, one ball, one strike. Oscar Torres. Barbosa is the new center fielder. As Torres misses away, two balls and one strike. We're in the 10th inning. It's a 4-3 Japan lead. And threatening to score a couple more. A base hit could be two more. That's driven in the air toward right, over the right fielder's glove, to the fence. One run is going to score. Two is going to score. Here comes the third run from first base, and a stand-up triple for Inoue. Clears the bases. Fujita scores. Toyonaga scores. Fujian scores. And all of a sudden, Japan has a 7-3 lead here in the 10th inning. That ball was pounded.
Now batting, right fielder number 6, Fuma Tanaka.
Gutierrez was in tight in the outfield. And he didn't miss it by much. It was only about a foot over his glove. But an inch over his glove would have yielded the same result. It doesn't matter. And now a 4-run lead for Japan here over Mexico. Torres. Strike. Such a good ball game. Here we are in the 10th inning. And these teams know what's at stake. You win, you advance. Swing and a miss. And that's the strikeout for the third out. So, Japan did their job here in the 10th inning. They score four runs, and they lead it 7-3. Mexico has a chance. They're coming to bat in the bottom of the 10th here. This is your 2023 Colt League World Series. So in order to advance, Tijuana, Mexico needs 4 runs to tie this game here in this bottom of the 10th inning. It'll be the catcher Atondo, third baseman Ballesteros, and first baseman Montiel. If anybody gets on, right fielder Gutierrez. Japan scores 4 in the 10th to take the 7-3 lead. Winners will play tomorrow at 2 o'clock. Losers will start making their trek home. Yota Takata stays in the game to try to close this out for Chiba Japan. An entertaining, great ball game between these two teams. That's driven toward left field, going back on it, over the head of the left fielder, Karanami. Off the wall, and a stand-up double for the catcher, Eric Atondo. That's how you start things for Team Mexico. And now it'll be Santiago Ballesteros. Takata has thrown 50 pitches. In relief of Kosuke Sengaki, who relieved Hoyoto Okanishi, who got the start. We're in the bottom of the 10th inning. That's driven toward center field. Now, Japan knows they have some runs to play with here. They don't have to be too aggressive defensively. One run is not going to hurt you. It's the back-to-back singles. But you don't want to give this Mexico team momentum. And they've got back-to-back singles to start this 10th inning. So now it's going to be Carlos Montiel that comes to the plate. The first baseman. Actually, it's going to be Eric Atondo. Curveball from Takata. Excuse me. Pablo Lamas is the pinch hitter. Yamas in for Montiel at first. The runner at first is Atondo. 1-2. Takata looks in, leans in. Ball in his right hand from the stretch. Runners at the corners. Two balls, 2 strikes, nobody out. 7-3 the score, up high. And Yamas leans out of the way of the ball. Three, two. The payoff pitch, 3-2. Inside walk seam, walks the bases loaded. That just typically spells trouble for teams when they do that. So now David Gutierrez, the right fielder, comes to the plate. Today, Gutierrez is grounded into 4-6-3 double play. He's had a sacrifice RBI. He's struck out and he's grounded out. He is 0-4. That could go a long way in keeping Mexico in this game with a base hit that could score 2. Bases are loaded. Nobody out. Takata on the mound. The pitch. Foul back by Gutierrez. Oliveros is the batter. On deck. Yoda, Takata trying to close out this game. The 0-1 up high for a ball, 1-1. The fans into the game. Team Mexico trying to tie this game up and extend it to the 11th if possible, or win it. And they have the bases loaded with nobody out. Takata on the mound. Two balls, one strike. Up high, 3-1. And as a pitcher, when you start missing high, you're not bending over far enough on your delivery. So the arm trails it. Leaves it high. Got to get back to your mechanics for Takata. The 3-1. There he got down. That's a strike. Full count now. Japan would take the double play. Mexico wants the base hit or the walk. A walk is a run. The 3-2. Driven toward the gap in right center field. And it is caught out there. They get it in quickly. They'll give up the one run. The throw home is not in time. And now it is a three-run lead for Japan. Matondo scores from third. Jesus Oliveros comes to the plate. Runners at first and second with one out. Takata from the stretch drives this one in the air toward left. Left fielder Kuranami. Kuranami there to make the catch, two down. And now it comes down to the center fielder, Oscar Torres, to extend this game. 7-4 is our score with two outs.
Now batting, the pitcher, number 6, Oscar Torres.
Torres from the left side. Big gap in right center field as Fujian plays straight away in center. They're guarding the line in right. 7-4, the score. Ball gets away. The runners are going to advance, so that takes, well, they don't need the double play. That's tiredness talking there. So runners in scoring position at second and third. For Oscar Torres, he struck out, popped out, grounded out, singled. 3-run lead for Takata. Swing and a miss. Good pitch. 74-mile-an-hour fastball from the right-hander. The atmosphere here is fantastic. One ball, two strikes, two outs, two on. Missed away. Deuces are wild. Two on, two out. Two balls, two strikes. Takata from the stretch, the pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out. Japan advances after the 7-4 win, a hard-fought battle here against Tijuana, Mexico. What a great ball game here this afternoon. Japan knocks off Tijuana, Mexico. Mexico had beat them in game one of the tournament. 6-0. And here they come back after beating Aroma Park 23-0. Yesterday, Japan advances to games tomorrow with a 7-4 win. We look at the box score. 7 runs on 10 hits. 3 errors committed by Chiba Japan. 4 runs, 13 hits. And 1 error by Tijuana, Mexico. 7-4, the final score. Japan plays tomorrow at 2. Tijuana, Mexico will return home after this heartbreaking loss. They've been fun to watch, though. Coming up next, we're going to have Southern Illinois and Rio Grande Valley, Texas. That's about 30 minutes away here on your YouTube channel for Pony Baseball and Softball. Thank you for tuning in to the 2023 Colt League World Series.
sitting visit SI, Ashley Spiller. Thank you to the Mexico Zone champion, Tijuana, Mexico, for participating in 2023 Colt World Series. Ladies and gentlemen, your Mexican Zone champion.